Hello everyone and welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. My name is Francesco, bless you, and welcome back to another feature. So in today's video, what we're going to be doing is chatting Notion again. Now you guys know that I particularly enjoy Notion. I love the experience and I've been talking about it for around about a year now. The application has been around for like a year and a half, but I've really double dosed in the last year. And actually, I believe I've created the most amount of videos on Notion in the last 6 months. So I do apologize if you are not the Notion lover out there. And maybe it feels like I'm trying to convert you, but I'm just making you aware of an application that's making a bit of waves at the moment. That's merely my opinion, and I'm enjoying it myself. So guys, I wanted to chat today about what's next for Notion. Now, you can go below and skip on the timestamps if you want to the different various elements of it. You can claim 2 months free Skillshare too in the description below. But guys, without further ado, let's dive in to Notion and what's next. So first up is the web clipper. Now Notion are clearly working on a web clipper. They've stated this. They want the web clipper to be installed on browser to some extent. They will allow you to clip stuff into Notion without the need to go into the application. And I think this is a great addition. Now, of course, Notion doesn't have an inbox because it's a flexible workspace. So you can create an inbox. And this is something I saw in David Pierce's setup.
Walk you through how I do my to-do list in a minute, because that's where I've spent most of my time trying to figure things out. But basically, the setup is trying to bring all of my personal stuff and all.
And he demonstrated it. I thought it was a great idea. So I've created my own inbox. Now, this web clipper will make that so much easier. For me, I clip articles into my Notion and have to do it manually, and it's horrible. So being able to actually do that with a web clipper will be fantastic. Now, next up is probably the most exciting element of Notion, which is coming up, API. Now, the API is important, and I'll tell you why. The API can add so much to Notion. Now, of course, I've had a couple of people mentioning, can you install the weather through a embedded weather application? I've tried it on the widgets. You cannot do that, which is a pain. But imagine being able to open your Notion and it to be reacting to with other applications. So for example, it could, and probably the biggest use of it would be Google Calendar. Imagine being able to use Notion for your Google Calendar, being able to plot activities, being able to add to it, and it to be part of your experience. So I'm definitely looking forward to that. And that's something that, especially two-way Google Calendar sync would be amazing. Now, as I was saying, the widgets would be amazing. Imagine being able to open up your Google, imagine being able to open up your Notion and seeing like a live tiles of all of the updates, and even being able to embed something like Todoist in there would be absolutely amazing. Now, the third thing I believe they're working on is recurring tasks. Now, reminders have been made available, but actually being able to create a recurring item inside of Notion would be really amazing and probably a big game changer for people, especially people who do routine things like cleaning the house. They could have checklists for cleaning the house to come up every Tuesday, checklist to clean, why is it always cleaning? You know what I mean, routine items that pop up, which is very useful, and being able to actually have a checklist behind that can be very beneficial. So they are working on some of their team elements, permission groups. Actually, that's something very specific. So for example, let's say you had a page and you wanted to give specific permissions to people per person, can be very useful. So for example, this is something Slack, I believe, has, like invites to channel or pages can be very useful, especially when you've got a large team and you're onboarding new people. The next is better inline comments. I actually started using the inline comments recently and they are not so nice inside of Notion. They are looking to improve this and want to reflect it in the same way of Google Docs so that people can see it in more of a chronological flow. Finally, the feature they have announced is Zapier integrations that they're working on. Zapier integrations would do a whole lot for Notion. So for example, when you're able to add stuff to Notion, for it to react to other applications, you could even have one that every time you add a Notion inbox, you add something to your Todoist inbox to nudge you that you've got something in your Notion inbox. So there's so many different ways you can use it. Obviously, that's a very simplistic use, but you could even connect it up with some of the more extensive applications that you've got. I think the next big update will be the API. API will blow everything out the water. If they have a Google Calendar two-way integration, wow. Honestly, it will change the way I use Notion. And definitely the way that other people use Notion for sure. So guys, that was just a short overview of where I think Notion's going. I will be trying to bring the CEO of Notion on very soon. I've emailed him, so hopefully he'll get back to me. And also I'll be doing a few more Notion features with David Pierce's setup coming very soon, the start of August. If you want to claim 2 months free Skillshare, you can do that below. And if you're not subscribed yet, hit that subscription button. If you liked today's video, hit like. And if you have any comments or thoughts, pop them below, because I'd love to hear what you think about Notion. Anyway guys, a huge thank you for today. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next feature. So without further ado, guys, I'll see you very soon. Cheers.